Well, hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. It's Friday night, and this will be a little bit of random numbness. There's probably too much to tell you, so I did want to touch on, though, the video deal, the two videos that I removed and that have been removed from my computer, and that's still unsolved. I'm going to give a best guess that there is something wrong with the YouTube editor, because the two videos that were still trying to process via YouTube 24 hours later and couldn't be accessed by anybody but me are the same two videos that were removed from my computer. Now, there's no other sign of any intrusion, no reasoning. I mean, the videos aren't super sensitive. I don't know why anybody that's watching me would remove those compared to the ones where I tell Obama he needs to be fucking immediately arrested. That might be one. Something like that. But I got plenty of other vaccine rant videos. I don't think that, you know, I didn't have an explanation, but after thinking about it for 24 hours, and I don't know for sure, so don't take this as a yes or a no, but I'm going to assume something in the YouTube editor, rather than just taking it, because it accessed the computer, obviously, to upload these videos, did it somehow in that process, does it have the ability to delete those from the computer when it's uploading them? That's just a common sense connection, and I don't know if it's even possible, but I'm going to throw it out there. So if you upload a video, okay, and you bring it into the YouTube editor, this is what I did. I upload the file, bring it into the YouTube editor, add the intro and outro. I don't know. I guess it wouldn't have anything to do with the YouTube editor. Maybe the upload function of YouTube for everybody has the ability to, when it's pulling up a video, inadvertently suck it out of your computer. I don't know. But as far as running around paranoid thinking the government got into my computer and took those two videos, I don't. Is it possible? Sure. And if that is the case, then they're trying to work on the fear factor, which I'm sure they've analyzed me enough to know that I don't fear anything. There is nothing worth my fear, see, because I have love in me, and there is no fear in love. There's anger. So if any of you psychoanalysts out there or marriage counselors who want to tell people that there's no anger in love, that's bullshit. If you don't love, you probably won't ever be angry, because it just doesn't matter. You don't care enough to be angry. So don't, you know, hate and anger are two different things. So you can, but anyway, there is no fear in me. Death. I don't think I'm going to die anytime soon. I don't know when that day is. I'm pretty sure I still have things left here that I need to do. And when the day comes that I die, anything that I'm responsible for here will be taken care of. It's always been provided for, whether that be my children, if they're not able, or whatever the case may be. Because it's always been the case. We eat, and we stay warm, and we have good people around us. So that's always been met. I have no reason to believe that that would ever stop. And when I'm done here, then I get to continue whatever it is I'm to do out there, which I think would be pretty cool to just think my way around. Now, the only sadness I have about all that is that divide. I won't be able to tell you how near Nibiru is, but just maybe come December we can see that together. So anyway, back to the fear. There is none. So if I'm wrong about this being a YouTube glitch, and this was some type of infiltration by government or some smartass, again, I'm not a tech guy. I don't know. I don't see any signs. But if it were, and you thought you were going to place some type of fear in me, sort of like visiting Greg Mann with the FBI, another YouTuber, if you haven't seen about that, go find Greg Mann on here and find out about his visit by four FBI agents. Fear doesn't work here. No. Fear does not apply. I have a goal. I have an existence. a reason for existence, and I have love, I don't need fear. No, I don't. So, that's that. I thought I'd touch on that. I don't think it has anything to do with a government operative or whatever. But, you know, the possibilities are endless. Which leads me to one of my favorite songs, Motorhead, The Game. It's all about the game and how you play it. It's all about control, and if you can take it. You're not taking control, and I'm not playing any game. I am the game. You are the game, he is the game, she is the game. Well, anyway, there's some random numbness. Anyway, oh, one other thing I wanted to touch on. Deceit and lies. Somebody that's really close to me sent in an email earlier that she didn't think that she was all alone and that nobody saw the deceit and the lies. And although I can't tell you exactly what she's referring to because there's so much, I reminded her she's not alone. I hate lies, and I see them all the time. Not just in the government, but the people. You know, how are we ever going to fix this country? We accept lies. You get all pissed off that the government lies to you every day. But when your friend with the stinky house calls and says, hey, can you come over? And you say, nah, man, I'm busy. Because you don't want to go there because his house stinks. Why couldn't you just say, hey, man, I'd like to come over, but if I do, we're going to clean up your place because it's a bit offensive, but I'll help you out with that. Or can I help you out with that? But no, you'll lie. It's okay. It's fine to do that, right? You can't take a chance of hurting anybody's feelings. And of course, you can't handle it in a mature enough way that you wouldn't actually hurt their feelings. But this is what I'm saying, these little lies, right? It's fine. Everything is acceptable. And now when you get it done to you, it really hurts, doesn't it? Yeah. So how are we ever going to fix things? We can lie, but they can't. You say you're pissed off that they're lying. You're lying too. What have you lied about today? So it's that special lady that said she thought she was all alone. You're not. It's everywhere. Lies, 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 lies. We run on it. We run on it. We exist on it. It's like a cell phone. Your everyday suburban life will not exist without at least one lie every day. Guarantee it. Put yourself in check tomorrow. Better yet, wait till Monday. Don't want to stress you out on the weekend. And I want you to be at work or interacting with the normal flow of things. Monday. How many lies do you have to tell to get through the day? Maybe when you stop lying to everybody else, they'll stop lying to you.